Hi, everybody. It's Olivia with the intention of the week, which is be present. That's it. It's not complicated this week. This is a pickup of an article that I had the blessing of writing for Essence.com this week, which is four feelings that you experience when you surrender to the present moment. I invite you to take it out if you would like. But what I want us to do this week is when we are doing any one thing, to do that one thing and feel what that feels like. I'm using feel a lot intentionally. If you're cooking, fine, have some background music in the background, but can you cook? And even if you've got kids around or a spouse or a partner around, a parent, what does that feel like to just be cooking? Not cooking and trying to text and trying to watch TV. Just try it out. If you're driving, of course, music in the background is great. But what if you drive just for a few minutes without any music in the background or without trying to text someone? What does that feel like? How do you feel when you really acknowledge how blessed you are to have the car that you have, whatever car that it is, to have the ability to get into a vehicle with your own feet and your own hands and drive where you want to go, to have gasoline in your car? If you are, let's say you're watching a movie, like I was this week, I watched the Selena series that was on Netflix. It was pretty interesting. But I remember telling a friend last night, I am going to put the phone away because for the next few hours, I'm going to watch Selena. I want to watch it. I don't want to be watching and texting. I want to get immersed in this television show. If you're with someone watching a movie, what about feeling what it feels like just to be nestled next to them versus trying to do multiple things at one time? And what I find is when we practice experiencing living in the moment, being in the moment, there are far-reaching effects. I think about relationships. Many of us women can relate to this. We start a relationship and we're already thinking 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, 10 years down the line. What happens if we just experience what it felt like that day? Appreciate what a conversation felt like to us that day with our partner, whether it made us happy, whether it made us sad, might have made us confused, but feel that feeling and trust that that feeling is going to change because life changes. Life is fleeting and for a moment. Feel what you're feeling and surrender to the present moment, the beauty of the present moment. I believe over time, that practice of slowing down and experiencing each moment by moment will benefit all of us. May God be with you. Please make sure you subscribe if you've not already, and I'll see you soon.